Hi, and welcome back to part 3 of lesson 1 of the Build Your Own E-commerce Website tutorial series. In the third part of this lesson, we're going to take an in-depth, detailed look at the sales component that we'll be creating on the site. And the first thing we'll be doing in the sales component is we'll be taking a look at the product section. Now, the product is defined by a variety of different elements. So the first part of the element, of course, is the product name or its title. Then you have the product description, and this is the large description, the expansive description of the product. Then you have the excerpt, which is the short summary description of the product. Then we have the price of the product. In this case, we're talking about an ebook as an example. So for the ebook, we'll have an author and we'll have a published date. We'll have a large image of the book. We'll have a thumbnail, a small image of the book. We'll have book reviews by customers. And we will have variations of the product. So for example, in this case, we look at the variations we have in our ebooks are English and French, and so you can pick a different language. And when we pick that different language, some of those different languages have additional fees associated with them, so that the variations can be more expensive or less expensive depending upon which is chosen. The second part of the sales component is the presentation of the products. And so, for example, you can see here on the site that if we go back to the home page, the first thing we have is this featured product. Now we have a little slider here that we're going to use to display the featured product, and the various featured products will show up as they slide through here. So we have the featured product view. We'll have the summary product view, which is where you can see the book name, a description of the product, its price, a language selection, and an add to cart, so you can just purchase it immediately. And then we have the detailed view. And the detailed view gives all of the information, not just the summary information, but all of the information that we're collecting about the site. It does include these various options. You can either add it to cart, or you can use the buy now option. And then it has all of this written description about the product itself. And this is the detailed view. Now, if you've been watching closely, you will have noticed perhaps that there's been an interesting shift in the URLs here as we've been looking. And that's because we are using both pages and posts for displaying this information. As you are no doubt aware, WordPress has currently two main divisions of data. It has pages, which are generally considered to be static, and it has posts, which are generally considered to be dynamic. What we have is we have pages and posts together. Our pages are our catalog and our product type page. So, for example, if you select the catalog, here's our catalog, and this is a page. And then if you select one of these, it takes us over to our product type, our catalog page. So all of our software elements are grouped together, just as all of our ebooks are grouped together. And this is also a page showing all of the products that are inside of this product type or this category. And then we have the posts. And the posts are really where all of the detailed information about the products are stored. In particular, there is the product detail that you see, as well as product meta information. And this information then is used to produce the teasers. And then you have the teasers. The teasers are created from the product detail and the product meta information. And those teasers become the summary information of the products that are displayed over here on our product type pages. So again, we can take a look at that site. So if we open up our dashboard and coming down and take a look at our product posts. So we scroll down here to, for example, this banana lust ebook and select edit. And not only do we have our detailed information, but we also have our post image or the large image. We have the small image or the thumbnail image. We have the excerpt, which is the summary information. And then we have these custom fields where we have put our author and the number of pages and the price and the product ID and the publication date and then shipping information and that sort of thing. This is our meta information. It gets translated both into our teasers and also into our display page. So the next what we have is our method of data entry. And so we have our product, and we have all these pieces of that product, and we have sort of a mixed data entry process, because we will enter the title, the excerpt, the price, and the thumbnail image, both in our WordPress e-commerce catalog plugin system, and also in the post, the WordPress post that we're using. And then we will do our description, our author, our publish date, our image, and our reviews. And those will all go exclusively inside the WordPress post framework. And then we have the variations, which will be exclusively inside of the WP e-commerce plugin. So we have all of these pieces of that data entry that we're going to have to manage and walk through. And then finally, we have our shopping cart. The shopping cart really has two functions. It has this buy now function that if you select on that buy now piece, it's going to take us directly to PayPal for an opportunity to purchase it. And instead of that, if you want to add it to your cart, you can add it to your cart and it'll show up as a shopping cart here, and you can in fact decide you want to purchase two of them, for example. So now we've bought two of them. We can say pick up one of these ebooks and add that one to the cart. And so now you have all of these things accumulating with shipping calculated and a subtotal and a total. And the person can decide to go ahead and check out now. And now it takes you back to the PayPal site where you can buy all three of the items. And that wraps up part three of lesson one of the Build Your Own E-commerce Website tutorial series. In part four, we're going to take a look at the information component.